Here's a look at Fury's numbers and London's matchup against the Hangzhou Spark. Whole lot of damage block there, guys.
I love that man, honestly, Fury. I've been rating him since the get-go. I'm his biggest fan. He knows it as well. Every time I see him in the corridors and the hallways, I always shout, Fury, and he runs away as fast as he can, probably because he's wondering why I'm chasing after him.
I think most do, Brent.
He is a fantastic player, and I'm so glad that now people have finally realized.
Yeah, a lot of people are talking about Mono and Mekko. Of course, we just saw Bumper and Janu, but when you look at this London Spitfire, they were kind of built on the backs of Gesture and Fury's play.
Yeah, and also I want to talk about Guard. We talked about him in the pre-show this morning, and we were talking about his Sombra, but in terms of his Brigitte, he had a high heal output. He was hitting the whips when he needed to.
This here, though, from Adora, look at this. He used the Brigitte shield to block the Transcendent. Again, it's these plays that I keep seeing. Every now and then, I lie, actually. It wasn't me that saw it, it was Reddit, and I just clicked it.
Thanks, Reddit.
But at the end of the day, these players, it does show that there is this high level of skill in the triple tank, triple support compositions that you need to watch out for. Apologies for interrupting you.
It's totally fine.
Yeah, it's another Brigitte player. But do you think Guard is as good on Brigitte as he is when he's on Sombra?
I think he fits the role that is missing when Birdring is on the roster. And
okay.
Prophet actually fits this niche role of Zarya very well. And there's this whole with Birdring, because you're switching Prophet, who's a really strong Brigitte, onto the Zarya. That hole is filled by Guard, and then you could swap Fury over as well. He's got the ability to play Sombra, but when you're running a niche Sombra cop, it's got to be Guard in that position.
Yeah, but that goes to show that London did their homework during off-season, because that is exactly why they added Guard into that, because they did identify that Birdring did struggle a little bit last season, so they brought him in and Flower to fill those gaps.
Now we do have to give some props to the Spark. They did pick up map number 4 on Dorado. This was a squad that started off so strong, but have definitely slowed down here in week 2.
Yeah, you know what? Brent and I are actually really frustrated. It looks like they need 3 maps to warm up and then they go ham again. And in the first 3, they kind of forget how to actually play Overwatch. It's really frustrating because they have so many good players. They have the right pieces to make it work. I don't know why it takes them so long.
That map 4 was absolutely a God's beast show, if you ask me.